Hey guys, Chris Fix here. Today we'll be working on Project Nightlight. Now what is Project Nightlight and why do I have all this metal out here? And why do I have a huge 42-inch LED light bar?
Well, Project Nightlight's gonna be installing the LED light bar on top of my truck.
I'm gonna use the factory post holes in the bed, make some bed rails, a headache rack, and then a little bit of an overhang for a slight roof rack. Projects like this don't just happen overnight, you just don't go out and buy metal and go at it. You have to come up with ideas, so I first sketched out an idea of what I want. Here's a crude version of my truck. And I wanted bed rails, a headache rack, and a little bit of an overhang so my light bar is kind of centered on the cab. And I kind of drew out a map view and all different views. And then I created my own rendering in Photoshop of how I wanted it to see how it actually looked. You can see here, this looks really cool. You got the bed rails, they're lifted up just a little bit so you could tie stuff down to them. It also protects the bed. Since I have this bed cover, it'd be good to have something that is kind of protecting it. So if I want to lie something on top, I don't even have to open up the bed cover. It also protects the back here, so if something slides into the cab, it won't hit the glass, it'll hit the metal here. And then I need some type of roof rack that stays right above the cab and goes about to where the door is. I think that looks pretty good, but it also prevents the light from shining on my hood. If you put the light bar up here, you'll get night blind with the light bouncing off the hood. This blocks out just the hood, but allows the light to go everywhere else. And here's what I mean. If we put the light bar right by the windshield, the light will shine on your hood, and you'll go night blind, which isn't good. You want the hood to be dark, and you want the light to shine right after the hood. So here's the LED light bar, which is the whole reason I'm doing this build. It's a 42-inch bar by Wharton, and it turns nighttime into daytime. This thing isn't a cheap eBay light bar. It has 39,000 lumens, and it has a lifetime warranty. Just wait till you see how bright this baby is. So I'll be using square tubing for this project. This small square tubing will be for the top of the roof rack, and the larger 1.5-inch square tubing will be for everything else. After we finish welding, we'll use Herculiner and give it a rust-free, super durable coating. Now to do this build, I'm not using any expensive tools. I have a metal grinder, I have a cutoff wheel with some extra cutting discs, and we have a 90-amp flux core welder, so you don't need to use gas, and it cost about $100, so really not that bad. You don't really need to spend a lot of money to do a build like this, and that's the whole point. And so we don't lose sight of what we're building, I'll put this right here. Let's start with the bed rails and looking into the post holes. The post holes fit a 1.5-inch tubing, and there are two on each side of the bed, one in the rear and one in the front. And I want the bottom of the horizontal tube to be level with the bed cover. So let's mark where we want to cut. Transfer the mark. To make sure it's level and a straight cut, I'm using a square and marking the metal with a nail. Then I cut one side at a time, using the square for each cut to ensure it's level. And now let's test it out and see. Perfect. That is exactly where we want it. Now I'm going to go measure and cut the other posts. Okay, so we got our four pieces of metal that are going to be our posts. They're all even. Let's test fit everything and see how we did. This is looking really good. It's nice and level. And we're already starting to see how this is going to look on the truck. This is going to have a post coming up to here, above the third brake light, so we aren't blocking it. But I'm getting ahead of myself. Let's finish the bed rails. I just want to check out to see how level the bar really is, because with the naked eye, it looks perfect. We have 55 millimeters in the back, and we have 52 millimeters in the front. A 3 millimeter difference is nothing, so this came out great. Let me quickly do the other side, and we'll see what it looks like with both set up. With the other side done, this is looking great. Now let's cut the ends off and weld this together. We're gonna make sure this bar is at the right spot to cut. So we're going to check the gap against the bed. I'm using this piece of wood to make sure the gap is even on both sides. Good. Mark off the spot we need to cut. I'm only going to show you cutting one side to save some time. You don't need to see me cut both sides. It's the same thing. It's like a mirror image. All right, let's test fit it. Slide this forward. Let's check out the gap between the rails and the cab. Perfect. Okay, this looks awesome. Both bed rails look straight, they're the same on both sides, and we're ready to weld them in. When welding these in, I'm gonna tack weld them together on the truck so we can make sure they're straight. So we're gonna be using this thick fiberglass blanket to prevent the weld sparks from causing damage to the paint or plastic on the truck. Attach the ground for the welder, get your welding mask on, and we're ready to weld. First, we're gonna tack weld the rear. And now we're gonna tack weld the front. Now with that tack welded in place, we can take the bar off the truck. Now I'm by no means a professional welder. I'm a self-taught welder watching YouTube videos and doing some reading on the subject. While I won't be welding up any roll cages or engine mounts, I can do projects like this, no problem. Let's clean the weld off. See, that's a pretty good weld, if I do say so myself. Let me weld the rest of this up and we'll test fit the bed rails on the truck. So we got some nice welds going. I'm gonna get some plates to fill back here, but I got the back welded as well. These welds will be ground down so they look decent. They're nice and strong, that's all that matters. And it looks nice and straight. Same over here. This is a pretty good weld. And we're done with one bed rail. So let's go do the other bed rail. And then we'll have to get a piece of metal here that goes up at an angle right above the third brake light. I tried using my extra welding mask over the camera lens so you get an idea of what I see, but the camera had a hard time focusing. Basically, when you weld, you're watching a molten puddle of metal and making slight C movements at an angle to weld the metal together. With the other bed rail welded, we can move on to the headache rack part of the build. Next step, we want to get these headache rack bars up, and then the crossbar. Here's what I want the headache rack bars to look like. They won't block the window at all, and they'll follow the curve of the cab. So now I need to cut this at an angle so that it lies flat on that piece and allows for an angle up here, and that'll intercept like that. So let's go cut that at an angle. I'm just gonna do it by eye and then fit it up. Sheesh. Got it the first cut. Not bad. Okay, now we're gonna use a piece of wood with cardboard, which is gonna give me the same distance from the cab on both the driver's side bar and the passenger side bar. Now I'm gonna tape up the bar so I can weld it in place. You can see that's the angle I want it at. I just want it right at the edge here. And it's gonna come up, meet the bar, and go across. So we're gonna go tack weld this in place. Okay, this looks good. I kept the angle I was looking for. Sometimes when you weld, the heat causes the metal to bend, but we're all good here. Let me quickly do the other side so we could do the crossbar at the top. I'm using the same piece of wood as the driver's side, which will keep the spacing even, and I'll angle the bar the same angle so it follows the curve of the cab. Now with it all taped up at the correct angle, let's weld it in place. Okay, we're on the last steps of this build, pretty much laying out bars that are going across that way and that way, and then one bar that goes across like this. So the next thing I'm gonna do is right here, I'm gonna cut and make it level so that we can put this long bar and weld it to the top. So I'm gonna level this out by eye and mark where I need to cut. Okay, so it's a little uneven, but I'm gonna take a grinder, and I'm gonna just grind this flat, and then this will sit right on top. So now I'm trying to follow this line right here, up to there. I'm gonna just do it by eye, and then I'll measure it. So that's where this bar is gonna end, right there. And you can see that's the plan. This actually, the picture goes a little bit further here. I want it to be a little bit further back, and that'll give us just enough light so that the hood doesn't light up, but we get all that light in front of us. Okay, let's see how it fits. So that's what it'll look like. Looks good. So I'm gonna quickly do the other side off camera. You don't need to see it, it's the same exact process. And then we'll weld these babies up. Okay, so we look here, got my two bars all set up, going across the top. This I'm gonna adjust a little bit. I'm gonna move this fiberglass sheet over. So this is just temporary, just to give you an idea of what it's gonna look like. I want them to run parallel. So I'm gonna start welding here. You can see I got my camera set up, so you get to see the welds. Okay, these welds are looking really good. The bar is nice and straight and level. Now the top bar of the headache rack will go across right here, but first let me finish the other side real quick. Looks good. So I know it's a little early, but I really couldn't resist. This looks so cool. I really can't wait to get this done. Let's go weld in that top bar on the headache rack. Now we're gonna measure across the top. Let's see what we get. And we're looking at about 42.5 right there. So we wanna cut the next piece to 42.5 inches. Okay, let's see how well it fits. Perfect. Let's go weld it in place. So that's welded into place for the most part. Now we're going to go to this side and weld this into place, and then we'll take it off and finish welding off the truck. Okay, this looks great. So let's take it off the truck and finish all the welds I couldn't get to. With our rig on the floor, I'm gonna say this is the end of part one. There'll be a part two, but in the meantime, I'll finish those welds that I couldn't get to on the truck. The next video link could be found by clicking on the video on the screen, and I'll also put a link for part two in the description. Hopefully you're as excited as I am. If you are, remember to give the video a thumbs up. And if you're not subscribed, what are you waiting for? Hit that subscribe button to get updates.